Guys, welcome to Chawla's Kitchen. Today I'm going to make something special. That's special because I love it. It's called Rajma. Rajma Chawal is anytime favorite from my childhood. So I wanted to share with you guys how we Punjabis make Rajma, because it's a Punjabi speciality dish. So whenever guests come to your house, you know, this is the thing we prepare at our house. This or either dal makhni. So let me introduce you what ingredients we need for this recipe. Here is Rajma, which I have already boiled. So, you know, just soak it overnight, or you can soak it in the morning and, you know, give it a 2-3 whistles in the evening. It would be done. So this is the consistency, like if you'll mash with our hands, it goes this way. This is what we need for our Rajmas. So I have used red kidney beans in this, and around 1 medium-sized onion, some ginger and some garlic, around inch of ginger and around 2 tablespoons of garlic, and I need around 3 medium-sized tomato. So what I have done is I have pureed tomato in a grinder. I like to do this way because this fastens the process. If you want, you can use the fresh tomato too. And for our condiments, I need some salt, some garam masala, some turmeric powder and some red chili powder. That's it. So let's start the process. Tempering, I have already put ginger and garlic in it as oil was heated up. So give it a stir. Put onion. I'm using around 1 medium-sized onion in this. Give it we have to saute this until it's like translucent. So it will take around 3-4 minutes to get that color. Then we'll be putting our tomato puree. My onions are done. Here goes my tomato puree. So 3 medium-sized tomatoes. And we have to cook this until it leaves oil from it. So at this point of time, here goes some salt, around 1.5 teaspoon of salt, some garam masala, around 1/2 teaspoon of garam masala, less than 1/2 teaspoon of turmeric powder, and some chili powder. Chili powder you can adjust to your taste. I have just used less. And I'll just cover this with a lid and get it cooked for 10 minutes, but we'll check back in 5 minutes. So it's around 15 minutes, and you can see on the edges, the sides, it have started leaving the oil. So this is the point where, you know, you can think that it's done, tempering is done, masala is done. So we need to be patient in making masalas, that is tempering. So unless it don't leave the oil, be patient, let it leave the oil, then only we are gonna put actual, you know, curries in this. Our tempering is ready. Here goes my Rajma. If you want, you can whistle it, you know, put it in a cooker, give it like 2-3 whistles. But I like to cook this way because, you know, and now we need to be more patient because we will cook it on like medium to high flame for around 10-15 minutes. Then we'll put it on a medium flame for around more 15 minutes. So we will cook it like this way with the covered lid for around 30 minutes now. So we'll check back after 30 minutes. And the reason we are giving this much time because we wanted masalas tempering to be really blended in to the Rajma, and we should get actual flavor of kidney beans. So let us check back after 15 minutes. Here goes the lid. My Rajma is like cooking for around 20 minutes, and now just only I have put the heat to medium. Just do one thing, take a spatula and, you know, press some Rajma this way. Why we do that? So that it's like you will get a thick consistency in the Rajmas. So this is a trick of our Punjabi Rajma. Be generous in putting all the masalas, onions, tomatoes, ginger and garlic, so that it gives a good flavor to our rajma. And don't put any rajma masala or anything in this, then only you will get an actual taste. So I'll give it like 5 more minutes, then it would be done. So after putting tempering in rajma, it took me around 25 to 30 minutes to cook it, like by covering the lid on medium to high heat, then on medium heat. So it's almost done. Look at the texture, look at the color. So this is the actual rajma masala we eat. So this is for my daily use. So I have not put any khada masalas in it. If you want, you can use that. If it's like party time or something, use that. But we generally don't use that. So here goes the trick of Punjabis, that is desi ghee. So add like a teaspoon of, in fact not a teaspoon, I would say tablespoon of desi ghee in it. Mix it well. Just turn off the heat, and here goes some cilantro on it. That's it. And this is a very yummy, tasty recipe. You can have it with rice, you can have it with roti. It really goes best with rice. Look at this yummy, delicious rajma. This is really delicious, believe me. Try out the way I have told you. This is one of my favorite recipe, and you know, you are really gonna love it. When I used to live in a PG, my auntie used to prepare this whenever I was like very angry with her, or you know. So this is the dish you should try with your kids also, and I assure you they will love it, and they will ask you to make it like every week. So don't forget to hit the like button, leave me comments and suggestions if you have any, and just subscribe on our channel to know much more yummier, delicious Punjabi and all over world recipes. Thank you for watching. Bye bye.